Now we're gonna work on footwork, same exact thing. Let's just say I have to move from here to over here. It's the same exact concept. I have three places that I can either lose or gain time. It is my exit, my run in between, and my entry. But if I crash into position, like most people will jump into position, if I jump into position, what happens to the gun? Crash. I may have gotten there fast, however, I crash into position, it affects my sight picture. I don't want that, it's ineffective. It's not good to be fast near the end. It's the same thing, 90-10 applies. 90% fast, and the last 10%, I have to start bleeding that energy and start shooting. So, in regards to movement, when I move from position to position, if I go from here to there, let's say I'm in the 90% right here, at that last 10%, I told you guys that the priorities change, and now I become accurate. That's gonna be my priority, is to become accurate. I have a threat or a target that I'm coming up on. What is the most important part? To get accurate by the time I get into the last 10% of the movement. Somebody. What is the most important thing that I need to do? Everyone knows this. Yes. Bleed out the energy. I gotta start bleeding out the energy, right? Because I can't run into position and break in position because it'll affect my sights. Stop bleeding out the energy. Second thing, number two, I'm just gonna say it, getting the gun up. If I get my gun up as I break the position, I can start going through the process of unpredictable, predictable, and steady. Rather than getting into position first and then presenting my gun on there, where I go through all three stages of the sights in the position itself. I wanna start starting the process sooner. The sooner I can start that process, the sooner I will be able to shoot an effective shot on the position itself. So the only thing I'm gonna talk about today, because this is only a 30-minute little demo, is my three-step entry. We're not gonna worry about the exit. That's a whole nother class in by itself. I'm gonna talk about the three-step entry, which is my three-step entry is when, if someone, there's a line here. I don't know if we can see that line. Right, and I came from a run. Whether I came from a run or I'm within 10%, meaning there's no opportunity for me to be fast, the 9 out of 10 way that I would enter that position is the three-step entry. I will not come in there with my left foot, my rear foot going to the right to left, and then my right foot follows before I present the gun. Or even if I present the gun with my left foot, I'm all twisted up, as you can see. Again, the same thing that we talked about, the same concept that we talked about in transitions. We talked about my lower half and my upper half being the same. When I come in this position, if I go with my rear foot, my lower half is facing this way. I got a target over here, I'm all twisted up and boggled up. So now I have two things moving, opposing, and then I gotta come in here and then try to settle and lock into that position. However, instead of doing that and trying to do it all in the position, I wanna start it earlier, and at this point, I wanna come in and enter from going left to right, I wanna enter on my right foot, and at this point, I have my lower half already in position and with my body, my upper half, which allows me to be able to be more effective sooner. The 90% concept is 90-10 concept is something that applies both in the real world and in the competition in regards to efficiency. Before I come in a corner, let's say I'm in the real world, I'm cutting in the corner, whatever. Do you get your gun up? You might not have it in front of your face because you have knowns versus unknowns in the real world. I might want to be able to scan what's underneath me. And if I'm coming around a corner, I have some sort of cover here, I want to be able to come in there, and what do? Slice the pie, right? Or whatever you guys do, you start working that, but at that point you have your gun. The last thing you ever want in that real world situation is to look, be face to face with the threat, and your gun is here. So now it's a race to who gets there first. I want to cheat as much as I can. I want to get that gun up as close as possible. So instead of having 2 feet of movement, I have about 6 inches of movement from here to there to the threat, which allows me to be faster, right? Efficiency versus being fast. So with that said, in regards to the entry, right, the three-step entry is this, and the reason why I have the three-step entry and I have these rules is because it allows me to stay present. Not only present, I can repeat it and I can be consistent, as what we talked about yesterday. It is all about being able to repeat my movement, so now I can start predicting when I should start seeing my sight picture and when I should be able to start shooting. If I don't see my sight picture by this time, I know I messed something up. I'd have to change the way I will engage, and I won't shoot any sooner than I need to because of my sights. However, here's the movement, the three-step entry. First step is breaking or stomping. The reason why I say stomp is because that's going to be the stimulus that I'm going to respond with my gun getting thrown on towards the target. From there, I'm going to enter with my lead foot. If I'm going left to right, I'm going to enter with my right foot. Applying the heel-to-toe method, as we are shooting on the move, we like to shoot with the heel-toe method. We are going to apply that same exact process here. As I enter, entering with the heel toe and then rolling in to position. The third step is just basically a trail leg coming into position as I set myself, right? 9 out of 10 times, I will come into position just like that. If I have to move over to the left, same exact thing, boom, boom, come in here, lock in. As you can see, I enter and then settle. Does that make sense? The biggest thing about this is bleeding out and breaking the energy, whether you stutter step and then you set, or you have the enough strength to be able to stop with one foot and then roll into position, right? So, is that clear with everybody? 1, 2, 3, right? So the one thing I want to talk about is that a lot of people will move correctly, they execute the movement correctly, however, they apply the steps incorrectly, which means I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to create this line here, and I'm going to enter in that position. I'm going to just keep my gun here. I don't really need my gun. As I enter the position, where's that line? Right here, right? So as I enter the position, I want you guys to tell me what I messed up here. What did I do? No, but I want to be past the line because this is my shooting area. But what did I do? One more movement. Where did I lose that time? Correct. So basically, I want to be able to shoot. My goal is to shoot after this, right? I just created this to give me a solid endpoint. What I meant by there was he noticed it. There was an extra movement at the end. It's because when did I apply my brake? My brake applied it on the position itself. So guess what happened? I had a very rough entrance, and I would have to now bleed that energy on the position. That stomp translates into the last thing that presents on the target, which is causing me a delay. And if I do shoot any sooner, I will not have the desired result that I've actually wanted to as I come into position. So this is very important, right? Where as I come into position, I want to break, and then I want to step into position as if I was walking on solid, thin ice of water, right? Where I don't want to slip and slide. I don't want to crash into position. I want to walk in it smoothly. So by being fast, it actually doesn't bode you well, whether you jump in position or not. It's much better and much more effective if I slowly roll into position. So the reason why that's important is because I want to talk about the numbers. 1, 2, and 3. I'm all about big and rhythm. The way I was taught in boxing was rhythm. 1, 2. 1, 2, 3, right? Like work the numbers and all that stuff. And sometimes you want to offset that 1, 2, throw it a little bit and then feint and then throw the number later. So basically it's the same thing here. Instead of just going 1, 2, 3 and just repeating the number, the rhythm that I want you to have is 1, 2, 3. So now it's 1, 2, 3. As you can see, a delay, the second and the third, that will force you to press the brakes way sooner as before you come into position. Same thing if I go to left, 1, 2, 3. As you can see, I'm already, by the time I'm in position, I can shoot sooner before my feet are even settled because my sights are already settled, already starting to become in a predictable pattern. Is that clear with everybody?